Good morning, everyone. So I'm Hemavindu Kasreddy. So today I'm going to talk about the mini project that is secure the React application. So this is the index we are going through today. The technological and project brief I have used. So JWT web tokens are being used so that whatever the data has been transmitted would be encoded with the help of it. Sign up and login page, we have mostly worked on this thing on this web application. So I would be explaining it to you in detail in future slides. Handling authentication state. So once you have logged in to one web application, one page, then you can access the same account at the same time in another web page also, because once we have logged in, we can directly go through it. I will explain it to you in future. So handling client side routing. So there are two things, for example, so admin and user. So admin will get some more, we can say, things to handle the web page, while the user might get two or more resources. So project API endpoints for protecting API endpoints. So for example, if someone is trying to change something, then he won't be able to do so because we have logged everything. Lazy loading the web page, so all the data, whatever is there, would be shown all once. We would be showing it step by step, or it would be doing like whatever necessary things would be there, it would be only shown on the screen. So cross-site scripting attack. So in the some people like attackers might try to do this kind of attack. So I have done sanitization. That means I have locked the web page so that they can't do this kind of attack on the web page. So adding proxy to the API. So some people might try to do changes to the API, like to bring some backend things to the front end, but we have logged it too. So in total, we have secured the single page. Like the main objective for this project is to secure the web application, whatever is there. So how is this better approach? So it decreases the chances of a data leakage. Lazy loading allows only limited data to be loaded or to be presented on the web page. JWT tokens are being used to encode the data transmitted. Cross-site forgery token has been added, due to which no one can do the hackers can't attack on the website. So architectures of the project is like front end I have used React.js, back end I have used Express.js, and the database is on MongoDB. So this is my project status and the timeline, like at what time I have done everything, and you would be able to understand like this much time is required to complete the project. So JWT tokens. So how I have added the JWT tokens, you can see. So here I have tried to add the email ID. Try to log in, and then I have added the password and clicked on login. So see, the account would be, the authentication is successful. So here our data has been transferred over there, and the JWT token has been displayed on this web page so that no one can this kind of data can't be displayed on the web page, but after some time we can't even show. Yeah, we have shown this data so that we can understand this is the time limit, like the people can expect this would expire at this time. So this is the sign up page. So people can sign up from this page, and if the email ID is wrong, then it will show the wrong email ID. So handling authentication state. So for example, I have logged in through one page. So that is localhost 3000. And then I have logged in through it. So here, once I will log in from this page, I can go to another page, and then I can show, like I can even handle the same. So see, I have opened another page, and from there I have opened, then I have clicked on get started. See, the account has been opened. So handling client side routing. So, for example, now I have logged in again through the. So I have clicked on Get Started. I have, and I am entering my email ID, the password. So from here, again, I am doing the login page, and I have clicked on Get Started. Here, if I have as I am an admin, so I have all these inventory, account settings, and everything. But if he is a user, then he won't get all these kind of things. So see, now you are able to see that the token has been here. It has been modified. So now if I'm refreshing it, so nothing is being visible because we have already protected the API from background. No one can do anything over there. So once they will do something, and then on the VS Code they would be getting this invalid algorithm. So in this way, I have protected my API endpoints. So lazy loading a web page, you might have seen that here, lazy loading, just this code has been used so that all the contents loads the important parts, that too very slowly. So performing cross-site scripting. So image source has been there, and what error should be there, and everything has been already added. So hima.com has been showed over there here. So let's see how it happens. So I have saved it. So bio has been updated. Now I will check from the user side. I will go to my bio. See, nothing is visible. So now I will inspect this, and I will try what will happen. I will check the network. I will refresh it so that we can get. So here, see, hima.com is visible. That too, it has failed. So now, see, this is the payload request. Payload there has been sent, but it has been failed from us from the by the web page. So now what we would be doing is we would be sanitizing the crosshair. So what I would be doing, I would be using DOM purify. In that, I will use the keyword sanitize from the it is already there in their web in the library. So I will use sanitize code so that now you will only see the hima.com won't be able to wouldn't be visible. So I have saved it. Again, same process I'm doing from the user. I'm went to Mamta, and then I have clicked on it. I'm again trying to inspect. So see, the question mark has been visible. So let's go and check for the network. So I'm refreshing it. Now see, hima.com is not at all there. So in this way, I have sanitized the cross-site scripting attack. And now we are going to see how adding proxy to the API. So I have trying to log in. So wrong mail and password has been displayed because the mail ID is wrong. So I will try to inspect it. So how we after inspecting, we are trying to change it. So see, failed to load resources. The server responded with the status of 403. 403 in the sense the authentication details are wrong. See, the authentication mail message is invalid. So this has been shown. So now how we will be adding proxy to the API. So see, wrong email or password is being there. So let's try to inspect one more time. So in this, see, the two errors has been shown. The server responded with the status 403, that is authentication has been failed. So let's try to go and check. And this is the way I have added, and these are my references. which have views. So I hope you have liked, so you have loved the project. Thank you.